Alexia Tsotsis from TechCrunch, and I'm here at Founders Den with FCC Chairman Julius Genachowski and SV Angel founder Ron Conway, and we're talking about desperately seeking spectrum. Why have you brought everyone together here today? I mean, what is the biggest problem with regard to spectrum? Just that it's running out and we need to figure out a solution before it's too late?
Well, the tech community wants to create awareness around this issue so that it doesn't become a crisis. And we have an FCC chairman that's very tech-friendly and comes to Silicon Valley often. And what we're trying to do today is raise awareness around an issue that could be catastrophic if we don't deal with it now.
Yeah, what we saw here today were a whole series of examples from entrepreneurs and innovators that are creating our economic future. They're creating new companies that are providing great services to consumers and small businesses, that are creating jobs, that are helping drive our economy, and we know exactly what the biggest threat to their success is. And the threat is that the infrastructure that they rely on, our airwaves, spectrum, is finite, demand is going up, supply right now is flat. If we don't increase the supply of spectrum, we're going to throttle the growth and the opportunity and the job creation we can get from mobile innovation.
You mentioned that the majority of spectrum infrastructure is invisible. What are some of the challenges of getting people to care about invisible infrastructure?
Well, it is the challenge, and the other point is the one Ron mentioned a few minutes ago. We can predict the crisis that's coming because demand is going up and supply is staying flat. And we anticipate that in about 3 years, we're going to start feeling as consumers and businesses the pinch of the spectrum crunch. Now, the problem is if we wait till then, it'll be too late because it takes time to reallocate and repurpose spectrum. So if we wait for 3 years and we see tremendous consumer frustration with drop connections, slow service, yeah, we'll get a big reaction and we'll be able to move the needle, but it'll be 3 years too late. It'll take another few years to make progress. And meanwhile, our company's growth will slow, and our global competitors who are looking at mobile innovation will leapfrog ahead of us. And that's why we have to move.
So you mentioned a solution, a measure called incentivized voluntary auctions.
Yes, voluntary incentive auctions.
And that's companies that have broadcast spectrum, giving up their spectrum for an incentive, obviously. Will this really help? It seems like the amount of spectrum used by mobile is exponential, and broadcast spectrum is pales in comparison.
No, we can free up a tremendous amount of spectrum if we have the authority to conduct voluntary incentive auctions. We can make a big dent in the coming spectrum crunch. We can create more time for innovators to develop more efficient technologies for spectrum use. It won't be the last thing that we'll need to do to make sure that we take care of our invisible infrastructure. We need to free up more government spectrum for mobile broadband. We need to find other ways that we can reallocate spectrum from older uses to newer uses. But everyone who's looked at this agrees that this is the best and biggest near-term opportunity to free up a very significant amount of spectrum for our mobile innovators.
And the tech community wants to be proactive on this issue. We don't want to wait until it's a crisis. And that's why we want to draw awareness to this issue now and get Congress's approval now for the incentive auction. Right now is when we need to act. And the tech community wants to support Julius and the FCC to accomplish this because we are being proactive.
So what is the opposition to the auction?
Change is always hard.
Any specific groups?
Well, the NAB has said that they don't see a big problem coming. They think to the extent that there's a problem, it'll take care of itself. What we've seen here is that the people who are innovating around mobile, investing in mobile, know that that's not the case. Now, there are many broadcasters who support this initiative, both very small broadcasters and very large broadcasters. So we need to get this done. It's exactly the kind of strategic action the country needs to take to make sure that we can be competitive in the global economy in the 21st century.
Yeah, there are some people that think that mobile is growing. Everyone would agree to that. What they don't understand, and Silicon Valley understands it, mobile is exploding. And we have to be prepared now, not at the point of crisis.
Did you say during the panel that Google, Facebook, and Twitter, 3 years down the line, will have 50% of their usership be on mobile?
Well, I don't know the exact numbers, but I'm saying that it is extremely dramatic. And I can't speak for any of those companies. That's a prediction that I'm making, you know, off the cuff. But the conversion from web apps to mobile apps is happening at a very, very rapid pace. And I said that number to dramatize how fast the conversion is happening, which I think some people in Washington don't realize.
So other than sign the letters that were under our seats and send them to our local or our congressman or woman, what can we in Silicon Valley, since we are problem solvers and we do tend to think outside the box and create the future, do to make sure that 3 years down the line we're not in a crisis?
Well, being engaged in these issues, helping educate the public about the tremendous opportunity that mobile innovation presents for economic growth and job creation.
You mentioned jobs per app. It was an interesting
Listen, as Ron said on the panel, 3 years ago, we didn't have an apps economy. Right? Today, there are literally hundreds of thousands of apps on the iPhone platform, on the Android platform, on the Microsoft platform. You know, even if you assume only one job per app, which I think is conservative, that's hundreds of thousands of jobs that have been created in the last 3 years on these mobile platforms. And that's just the beginning, right?
Right. And we certainly don't want to stifle that, because the biggest crisis facing America today is job creation. And the mobile app economy is going to be a significant contributor to the solution of that.
So ideally, do you have a rough estimate of how much spectrum we need to support our mobile industry moving forward?
Well, we'll need more and more over time. If we can recover, the president has set a goal of freeing up a total of 500 megahertz for mobile broadband by 2020. And it's our estimate, it's the best estimate of what we need to do to keep pace with mobile innovation. 100 megahertz from broadcast spectrum would make a very significant dent in that, particularly given how high quality the spectrum is for mobile broadband use. As I said, there's also other avenues we need to pursue. We've been able to recover some spectrum already, but this is the single biggest lever we can pull to meet our national goal of recovering 500 megahertz from mobile broadband.